this is very interesting.
It's so awesome and we love it.
And this sucks, yay!
Yeah, so, Mike here with, my best friend Daniel. And today we will be doing a review on Borderlands. Yes, this is one of the, well, what I believe is this is one of the best games 2009 easily. So, yeah, just be talking about it and going and, yeah, killing people while we're doing it. So I think that just the artwork in this game is phenomenal. Like, it's so different than the Call of Duty series and everything. So, if you're looking just for, an outrageous different game, kind of funny, got a bit of humor in it, Borderlands is definitely the game for you. So, yeah, like I just said, the artwork in it is just so good. It's so just when you shoot somebody, man, the guts fly everywhere. It's such a gory game. Not recommended for children my age, but you don't follow every single rule in the world. Yeah, the storyline is basically you go to a planet called Pandora to find the vault. Now, the vault holds a lot of money and, like, guns. I'm not gonna give away like a spoiler about what happens at it. Kind of a bummer, not gonna lie. But yeah, you'll like it. Just go in. There's side missions too that are just awesome. There's a bunch of bosses such as Nine Toes. He's easily my favorite. Just his quote is awesome. Alright, so now what we're going to talk about is the special abilities that you get, like you just saw me do. So, I play a siren, I'm level 55, and I can go into this thing called Phase Walk, where nobody can see me, except for my teammates, and I have incredible speed. And for the soldier, he drops down a turret, shielded, so anybody that passes by it, just gets shot down.
My favorite.
Which is, yes, Daniel's character, his favorite. But the thing is about it, if you jump behind it, it's immune. It's just nothing. And probably one of my favorites is the hunter, where he throws this bird, and it just kind of gnaws at him, if that could be a correct word to say. So, and, of course, the main character, I believe, is Brick, as himself, as they would say, because he's a huge guy that looks like he's on steroids and has pounds of testosterone in him. And his special ability, what do you know, it's his fist. So he'll come up to you and punch the shit out of you if you're doing the duel against Brick. As you can see, every kind of enemy or animal in this game has a critical hit. So, as the skag would do, it would open up its mouth to attempt to just jump at you and try to eat you, right? The human is, of course, the head, too. And that's pretty much just both of the characters, the skag and the human in this game. There's not an exactly wide option of creatures that you can fight, but it's still, it's fun to go around and kill people doing the side missions and everything. It's just a good time. You can beat it. You can beat it like twice at two playthroughs you get to do, and you still want to play it. And what I think is the best of the game is the downloadable content. So now, we're gonna get into the heavy metal shit. The cars. Which I think are just awesome. Two people can ride in it. It's like a great addition, because a lot of these games don't have any cars. And it's just like a buzzkill. Like, let's say if Black Ops had like, that was a fail, if Black Ops had like, a car in it, that would just be kick-ass. I guarantee everybody would play it. But yeah, so Borderlands, even if you just want to like, drive around in it, you can splatter people, there's really everything you can do in a guitar. So yeah, Borderlands is a great game. Some of the parts I don't exactly like. Story mode gets boring eventually when you do it, but overall, it's just a fun game to play whenever you are, whenever you feel like it, you know, just play it. The cars are phenomenal in it. You never get bored. The verdict of this video is 8.5.